Vehicle, please. The Knackered Golfist, now driving.
Random golf memory of the evening. Right now I'm remembering George Archer. George Archer won the Masters many, 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 many years ago. I believe it was 1969 is when he won the Masters. In 1996, I did an internship at Incline Village Resort in Incline Village, Nevada. I was sort of a grounds sort of intern at the executive course, but I used to love to go to the championship course to go hit balls on the range because they gave us free golf balls to hit at the range, however long they were. I mean, because I was an employee there, and I worked there during the summer of 1996. And just from my memory also, I used to have a set of the Walter Hagen The Hague irons. And anyway, so I was hitting balls, I think, on the left side of the range. And I knew that George Archer was sort of based in Incline Village because he was still playing the senior tour. And from what I remember, I was sort of doing my own thing. I was noticing that George Archer was there, sort of hitting balls and talking to people or whatever. And I think I deliberately sort of chose a stall that was near him because I wanted him to sort of, you know, either notice me or strike up a conversation with me or something like that. But it seems like he was there and he was sort of maybe randomly talking to people or something like that or whatever. So what was going on is I was hitting my irons. It could have been a 7 iron, it could have been a 5 iron, I don't know. But I guess he was finished with a conversation with a lady, and I guess while I was hitting balls, the lady said to me from with my back turned to her, "He's watching you." And I said, "Oh, who? Mr. Archer?" And so I think I turned around and I asked him, "So, Mr. Archer, how am I doing?" And he says, "You're too fast." And so I don't know, he didn't take the club out of my hand and sort of show me what to do, but I think he motioned that I was I had good ball striking qualities, and he said, just slow it down and sort of not be so rushed to hit the ball. And so I just thought of that just in the last few minutes. And George Archer won the Masters in 1969. He also won the Rayleigh Senior Gold Rush back in the, I don't know what exact year it was. I think he could have won it twice. I'm not sure if that's true or not. But he, I remember him, he used to play with a Ping Answer 4 putter. And that's what I remember him using when I saw him on the senior tour back in the day when that was the first generation senior tour was, first or second generation, but he was with this company called Bullet Golf, and I think that the Bullet brand was sort of basically on the senior tour. I think George Archer played Bullet, Harold Henning played Bullet, and he was a South African guy that I have another story about, so that'll be in another one. But Bullet was sort of a, they had a blade that I think was either cast or it was forged. I think they had both options. They had forged Bullet blades and that sort of thing. So anyway, random golf memory of the evening, George Archer, that happened at Incline Village, Nevada in 1996 with me, Trent, from the Knackered Golf. One other thing about George Archer is that I remember when he played for Bullet Golf, he was a staff member with Bullet Golf. He was on it with Harold Henning and Simon Hobday. both of those guys were from South Africa, and then it was George Archer. And that's, I think those are the three guys that I can remember right now that played bullet golf back on the senior tour in the early 90s. And then I wanted to make another comment about George Archer. And I heard it on the No Laying Up podcast when they talked to Peter Costas. George Archer was 6'5", and I'm 6'5". And back in his day, there was very little sort of availability in having golf clubs for a taller player. And so he had to make do with what was available on the market. And which, I mean, I think at the time, Ping was doing custom golf clubs from what I'm hearing on the old Ping group page, that they've been available since like 1967. But I don't know. Ping, all I know about George Archer is that he played a Ping answer four putter, and that's all I remember. So I guess he had to make do with golf clubs that were out on the market, and he had to tweak them however it was. So, and he was also from Gilroy, California, which is on the hot side of the mountains on the other side of Watsonville, down off of Highway 101. So Gilroy gets really hot there in the summer, but he was from Gilroy, and he was sort of, he won a major. He won a major, and he was from Gilroy, California, and he was probably the only Californian, Northern Californian, other than Johnny Miller, to win a major. So, and also Ken Venturi. Ken Venturi was from San Francisco. And you know what? Another thing is that they just had the TPC Harding Park held the PGA last weekend. And I was looking up, I looked up an event that happened at Harding Park back in the, it started in 1961, and I think it went to 1969. It was called the Lucky International Open, something like that. And it wasn't Lucky Grocery Stores, it was Lucky Lager that had this PGA Tour tournament, from 1961 to 1969. From what I read on the Wikipedia page, it went from 1961 to 1967, and then they didn't have the event in 1967, and then it went two more years, 68 and 69. And what was interesting about that is that the Lucky International Open held at Harding Park was held the week after the Bing Crosby Pebble Beach tournament in February, I think. Or it could have been in January, I'm not sure, because the Super Bowl and that didn't sort of line up until much, much later, which I thought was fascinating. And I've always thought that why can't Harding Park have a normal, regular PGA Tour stop in Northern California other than Pebble Beach? And back in that time, they did. You know, they had the Pebble Beach first, and then they had the San Francisco Open, or they called it the San Francisco Open, something like that. Anyway, I'm rambling on. But anyway, George Archer, my random golf memory, and me sort of reminiscing about the senior tour from back when I remembered it back in the early 90s, and how far we've come with golf and with the history of golf and players and equipment and golf courses and sort of the age that we live in and the age that we came from back then. So anyway, thanks for watching The Knack of Golfist, and stay tuned for more random golf memories on this channel. Thank you very much.
Four, please. The Knack of Golfist, now driving.